It turns out that in trig, two triangles appear over and over, and I want to introduce you to those triangles now. Now, this is going to be the first triangle down here, and we're just going to use this to motivate the relationships that we see down here. This triangle I can see is 60, 60. Now, if all the angles add to 180 for any triangle, that means this angle must be 60 as well. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw a perpendicular bisector starting at this vertex. That is, I'm going to bisect that angle and draw a line segment that will also bisect the opposite side. Let's go ahead and do that now. So I'm drawing in what's called the perpendicular bisector. Okay, and that creates a 90 degree angle here. Now that bisects this angle, right? That means each of these is 30 degrees. So this is 30 degrees, and so is this. This is 30 degrees as well. Okay, so I've created, in both cases, 30, 60, 90 triangles, right? Now, if this is side, if I say that this is side, you know, of length 1, okay, and if that would make this of side of length 1 as well, because the original triangle was an equilateral triangle, right? Now, if this was really a perpendicular bisector, that must have divided this into two pieces, right? Two equal sized pieces, and that would make each of these of length 1/2. So if I start with the assumption that all the sides were originally 1, then these must be 1/2. Now the question is, what would this length be right there? So we can figure that out using the Pythagorean theorem, right? So this is a right triangle, so we know that x squared plus, well, this side squared, right? That is 1/2 squared is equal to the square of the hypotenuse, which is 1 squared. Okay, so we get x squared plus 1/4 is equal to 1. And if I subtract 1/4 from both sides, I get x squared is equal to, it's going to be 3/4, right? 1 take away a fourth. And then if I now use the square root property, I get this. X is equal to plus or minus the square root of 3/4. Now, x represents a length, right? It's the length of this segment here. So it's got to be positive. And I'll break this up. I'm going to write this as x is equal to positive square root of 3 over 2. Okay? Now what that means is this. If you start off with a hypotenuse of length 1, right, in a right triangle that's a 30, 60, 90 triangle, then the side opposite the 30 degree angle is 1/2, and the side opposite the 60 degree angle measures root 3 over 2. Let's write that relationship down here. So this is a 30 degree angle here. Okay, and this is a 60 degree angle there. So I've got a 30, 60, 90 triangle. And if the hypotenuse is of length 1, then the side opposite the 30 degree angle, right, the shortest side, must be of length 1/2. And the side opposite the 60 degree angle must be the square root of 3 divided by 2. Okay, this is our first of two very important triangles. You want to memorize these relationships. So whenever you have a 30, 60, 90 triangle and the hypotenuse is at length 1, the shorter side is 1/2, and the middle side, if you will, that is the side opposite the 60 degree angle, is the square root of 3 over 2. So now it's important to realize that this whole triangle can be scaled up or scaled down. So for example, if you had a triangle where the hypotenuse wasn't 1, but like let's say where the hypotenuse was 2, and it was still a 30, 60, 90 triangle, let's see what that would look like, for example. So something like this. All I've done is I've drawn a bigger 30, 60, 90 triangle, right? Now what I've basically drawn is one where the hypotenuse isn't 1, but where it's 2. What's important to note is that all these relationships are still the same. That is, the side opposite the 30 degree angle is still 1/2 of the hypotenuse. Well, if this is the hypotenuse and it's 2, 1/2 of that would be 1, right? So the side opposite the 30 degree angle is still half of the hypotenuse, and the side opposite the 60 degree angle is still root 3 over 2 multiplied by the hypotenuse. Well, if the hypotenuse is 2, root 3 over 2 multiplied by that 2, that would just be, the 2's would cancel and I'd get just root 3. So this length would be root 3. So what's important is the relationships, right? Now, these triangles are called similar. So similar triangles are ones where all the angles are the same. They're basically like enlarged versions of each other. But if you remember this relationship, 1, 1 half, and root 3 over 2, you can always scale up any 30, 60, 90 triangle, okay? So this is the first of two important triangles. Let's go ahead and see the second now. Okay, so once again, this is going to be our important triangle, and we're just going to work with this one up here to see what the side should be. So why don't we start with some lengths? Why don't I assume this length is 1? Okay, now this is an isosceles right triangle. So it's a right triangle, right? This is 90 degrees, but each of these are of measure 45 degrees. Now, because it's isosceles, these sides must be the same length, right? So I'm going to label both of them x. So once again, using the Pythagorean theorem, must be the case that x squared plus x squared, right? The sum of the squares of the two sides is equal to the square of the hypotenuse, which is 1 squared. So that gives me 2x squared is equal to 1. So I get x squared is equal to 1 half. Now once again, using the square root property and noting that the length is positive, I get this. X is equal to the square root of 1 half. Now that can be written in the following way. The square root of 1 over the square root of 2, which is 1 over the square root of 2. Now if you rationalize this denominator, that is multiply top and bottom by the square root of 2, you get this. X is equal to the square root of 2 in the numerator, and the denominator is going to be 2. Okay, what that means is that if you have a 45, 45, 90 triangle, like I do here, and the hypotenuse, once again, right, that is the side opposite the 90 degree angle, is of length 1, each of these sides must be the square root of 2 over 2. So this is the square root of 2 over 2, and the same with this one. Okay, and this is the second of our two important triangles. Now, once again, it's important to realize that if you scale this up or down, you have simply scaled these relationship or these numbers up or down. Okay, so in other words, if the hypotenuse was 2, then this wouldn't be root 2 over 2, it would just be root 2. It would be double this, and the same with this, right? So if I multiply the hypotenuse by 2, I would also multiply each of the sides by 2 as well, just like I did for a 30, 60, 90 triangle. So if you memorize that whenever you have a 45, 45, 90 triangle, and the hypotenuse is 1, that the sides are of length root 2 over 2, you can always scale this up or down as needed. Now, a legitimate question is, why are these triangles so important in trig? And that's a good question. Let's go ahead and address that now. So what we're going to be doing is we're going to be taking circles, and we're going to be looking at angles within those circles. So remember how an angle is going to go. We're going to make this the initial side of our angle, and then we're going to draw in a terminal side of our angle. Let's go ahead and do that now as an example. Let's say this was my angle. So my angle is all the way here. Okay, this is my angle theta. Now, when you find the trig functions, it turns out, of an angle, what matters are three quantities. The coordinates of the point where the terminal side meets the circle, so that would be the coordinates x, y, we're going to need those, and we're also going to need the radius of the circle, which is r. Okay. Now, what's going to happen is, to find x, y, and r, what we're going to do is we're going to look at the reference angle. Now, the reference angle is the angle that the terminal side makes with the x-axis. And to do that, we're going to draw in a right triangle. So we're going to draw in a triangle like this. Okay? So this is a right triangle. And you can see this little triangle here, Well, sometimes you're fortunate. That is, you hope that it's either 30, 60, 90, or 45, 45, 90. So for example, I drew one that was where the reference angle, where this was 60 degrees, and this is 30 degrees. Okay, and you're in luck, because if you know what the radius is, right? Well, we know for a 30, 60, 90 triangle, the relationships are always, the numbers that are important are 1, 1 half, and root 3 over 2. And so it all depends what your radius is, right? If your r is 1, then this length would be 1 half, and this length would be root 3 over 2. And that's going to allow us to find our x and our y, because the x and y are coordinates of this point, and all you have to do is take these lengths and either keep them positive or keep them negative. It all depends which quadrant you're in. But my point is that when you're evaluating trig functions of an angle, as we'll see in the next video, you have to be able to create a reference angle. And when you do that, you actually create a triangle, and you hope those triangles are one of the two important triangles we just discussed. Okay? So you want to remember those two important triangles, and in the next video, we'll talk about how to make use of them to evaluate trig functions. Okay, until next time.